100
moles
of liquid.
Yeah.
It's pure shit.
The E. coli count is 500 mil.
Oh, no, it's over 5 million per 100 moles of liquid.
Okay, and the children are playing in it.
And the children are playing in it, yes.
Levels of the E. coli levels within the lagoon, and Ed unfortunately was the body that was then tasked to do a few things. And in the interim, what we had done is that we had a few EPWP folk that was cleaning the beaches. We employed our honeysucker, is that what it's called, Ed, to get rid of some of the blue waste that was emanating from the informal settlement. We tried to get them to clean the rubble or the litter that was coming from that storm water, and then to move the grid that was currently there, move it back so it was able to catch more of the litter that was getting into the lagoon. But since then, clearly that was just an interim measure into the bigger problem that we were faced with. And Ed then proposed, and Ed, I really, really want you to support him and give him a hand, and I'll tell you why. He has found money to do something in this financial year that I never thought he would have. And that is why we are here today. There is another part of the whole development that I would like to bring back to you, but this is the first part of the development, which was the more pressing issue about the lagoon. And Ed is going to say to us about a few hot spots around the lagoon. How does it work? How is it going to work?
That's what I'm going to explain to you now. This is I call it like a diversion chamber. This is a typical example which is working very well. This is in Kaimandi in Stellenbosch. We went to visit this plant, and that was a couple of years ago. It's actually working very good. Okay, this works to the others. Yeah, that's also part of the diversion chamber. So you can see here, this is the actual contaminated stormwater reaching into this chamber over here. It's like a sluice gate and a grid system. From there, the water goes into the sewer system. The same, that is just from another angle. Okay. That's just some more pictures of the chamber itself. This is just an example. Okay, so this is what we earmarked. We actually got money for this financial year. And we divided the whole area up into, call it like, three major projects. Project one, well, that is the yellow, all the yellow circles. So what we're going to do is we're going to pot crack. A pot crack is a traceless rehabilitation method, where we actually literally pull in a new pipe into the old pipe. And also what we're going to do is we're going to upsize it. So we're going to make all those diameters, we're going to make them bigger. Two-way, to accommodate more flow, and secondly, it will limit the amount of blockages, obviously. And then project number two, also upsizing and rehabilitating the existing system. I'll get to another slide, just not just the cost on that. Then project number three. They're not in the near order of one. We're going to start with one, two, and three. Project three is a diversion. You see there, all of these, the stormwater, as it just now explained, ended up there, and from there, it's parked all the way down to the lagoon. So what we envisage doing is catching contaminated low flow. Just remember the low flow. We can't cater for the storm interval when it's raining. Then the storm water will go to the lagoon. But the low flow is the continuous dumping of sewage into the stormwater system. We're going to catch that up over there. We're going to divert that to the sewage pump station over here. That blue line is going to be the new diversion pipeline. So we're going to have a diversion chamber over there, catching the low flow, and then it's going to be pumped to the pump station over there. And later, there's some more slides where I'll explain to you how the whole reticulation system will. Already, you know what the problem is. The first of the problems, obviously, the population, where they're staying, and the existing system that was originally designed wasn't designed to cater for the amount of people that's actually staying in Phoenix and Joe Slovo. The exact numbers, don't have the exact numbers, but obviously we can see in the regulation system that the system, the current system, can't actually utilize all existing flows